I kind of want to switch it up a little bit. My channel really gonna be like a variety type of deal. You know, I might talk about some sports and talk about what's going on in, like, around my hometown. You know, cities close to it, for that matter. You know, I'll say that to say this, man, bring awareness, man. It's a lot of kids. It's a lot of kids getting killed in the Michigan streets, man. It's a lot of kids getting killed in the Michigan streets. It's crazy. It's crazy because my girl, she got a nephew. Now, the story I'm getting, as far as what happened, as far as close family members, is that he upped the pole. He's 16, mind you, he's 16. He upped the pole on a man in his 40s. The man was defending his girl. He must have disrespected the man's wife. The man probably, you know, standing up for his wife, come out standing up for his wife. You know, letting young blood know. Like, come on, bro, it don't take all that. Up the pole on dude, gun jam. They say old boy came back, shot him. It's crazy. So he up the pole on the older cat in his 40s, the 16-year-old did. 42-year-old pulled his strap out. It's sad, man. It's sad because these kids out here with these guns, man. That was a scenario that happened in my city. You know what I'm saying? My hometown city. Almost the same thing. You know, gun jam or whatnot, but I don't know. I don't know where these young cats getting these guns from, man. I know they about breaking in these gun stalls. You know, being somebody fall boy, and it's crazy because they don't know no better, man. Whole life ahead of you. Whole life ahead of you. You know, it's... And it's crazy because he was out here young and thugging. He was young and thugging, man. The parents didn't really want nothing to do with him, to be honest. Because if they did, he would have been staying with one of them. He wasn't staying with neither one of them. He was basically on the streets. If you ain't staying with your mom and pops, you basically on the streets, bro. At 15, 14, 13, shit like that. It's sad, man. It's a sad situation, man. These kids with these guns, man, they ain't trying to be all they can be. They ain't trying to be all they can be, man. I've been a gun owner for years. Thank God I don't got no felony, so I can ride with it. You know what I'm saying? And not look over my shoulder. But they can't say the same. They coming up with misdemeanors, felonies at 14, 15, 16. But rest in peace to a young dog, man. It's sad, man. It's sad. It's very sad. But we need to, we need to step up, man. As fathers and uncles and cousins and older males, man, and slap their head, man. Put that gun down, bro. What you doing with that, man? Take it from them. No, it's gonna be hard, but you gotta bully them, man. You gotta bully their brain into something different, man. Show them something different. That ain't gangster, man. That's not gangster at all. That's not gangster, man. Y'all trying to be gangster, man. Take care of moms, man. Get some money and take care of moms. She couldn't take care of you. I ain't gonna say she couldn't take care of you, but your actions is help out. Be smoother to the point where she ain't gotta worry about you in the streets, bro. You know what I'm saying? And I'm speaking to the youth on this one. I'm speaking to everybody. Young and old. We gotta do better, man. We gotta do better, man. Our culture's so messed up, man. It's like, you don't see no other groups of people, man. Like, you don't see no other ethnics. No, you know, you don't see that, man, out of other people, man. You don't see that at all. It's crazy. Crazy as it is, man, it's reality. It's our harsh reality. And this one it hit me hard, though. It hit home. It hit me hard, though. You know? Like, comment, subscribe. I'm out.